Let's look at adding an event. On the front page, events always populate in the upcoming events section from the closest to the furthest away. To see all events on a website, you can simply hit More Events, and you'll be greeted with a grid layout page, kind of like this one. And you might notice at the top, there's also filter options where you can sort by date, topic, keywords, things like that. To add an event, I'm going to hover over Content, Add Content, and click on Event. This brings me to the editing interface for a new event. Now my boss has already sent me some materials they need to put on the website, so let's take a look at those. And it looks like I have a picture and a story. So let's start with the text because that's a little easier. So this looks pretty simple. I'm going to copy and paste the title into the title field in Drupal. And it looks like my date was January 15th, 2020, from 5 o'clock p.m. to 7 o'clock p.m. So in the time area, I'm going to write in 01/15/2020. And in the time, I'll put 05/00/00 p.m. And it'll end the same day, so January 15th, 2020, at 7 o'clock p.m. My location was in Mendenhall 220. And my description, just going to copy and paste this over. Now, you might come up with this pop-up box, and this is because when copying from Word, Drupal needs to strip out some extra code and things that can mess up a web page's layout. So I'm going to hit OK and let Drupal do its cleaning. And you might notice a few extra spaces in here, and this is because of the conversion process. So I'm going to remove these by hand. And then finally, the image. Now, images for events are always in 3:2 ratio. And I'm going to guess my boss probably didn't give me an image in that format, which is okay because I'm going to open it in Photoshop. Now that we're in Photoshop, I'm going to make sure I have the crop tool selected. And I'm going to change my ratio to 3:2. And this looks about right. I might want to bring it up just a little bit. And then I'm going to hit the checkbox up here to finalize the crop. And now to export the image at the right size. And this is a really important part, and please don't skip this. So I'm going to go to File, Export, Export As. I'm going to make sure the format is set to JPEG and the quality to 75%. And this gives a pretty good trade-off between image quality and file size. And then I'm going to set the width down here to 600. And this should automatically set the height to 400. If I click out, you see it changes to 398. Yours may change to 401, 601, something like that. It's fine. It doesn't have to be exact. So I'm going to go down here and hit Export All. And now I have a choice of where to save it and what to name this. So I always like to name it by the place it's going to be in, so events. And then the subject matter. So this was an event for student meet and greet. And I'm going to save this to the desktop. That's fine. I'm going to hit Export. And now, if I come out to the desktop, we have our second image right here. I'm going to switch back over and go to Select Images. Since this is a new image, I'm going to upload it. So go to Upload Images. And I can drag and drop files directly onto this gray area or hit Select Files and choose the image I want. Now your image will pop up down here and you'll need to fill in this alternative text box. So this is a short description of the image used by screen readers and displayed when the image is not loaded. And this is a fairly simple image, so I'm just going to put in two students conversing, since that kind of describes the subject matter of the image. And then I'm going to hit Select Images. This loads the image into my page. And before we leave, there's a few extra options down here. Now, your site may not have these, or they may have different ones. These are taxonomy or filter options, and these are how you can categorize different events or news, any type of item on your website. Here, I might just put academic and then meetup and then hit save. And our event appears on the site. We can add it to our calendar. If I go out to events over here, it's going to show up on the page for me and all the way out in the front. We have our event. Now that we've completed this topic, choose the next video on the right side of the screen or view the entire playlist with the link on the left.